Our planet, Earth, the magnificent planet we live on, is filled with endless discoveries and mysteries. Every day, we see only a fraction of the soil beneath our feet. In fact, deep within the Earth lies a complex and marvelous structure. This structure has captivated scientists, researchers, and curious minds for years, inspiring countless discoveries. Earth's layers have intrigued humanity for centuries, mesmerizing scientists. These layers, stretching from the crust to the core, are fundamental elements that determine how our planet formed, evolved, and even how life is possible on it. The crust is the layer that covers Earth's outer surface and forms the outermost shell of the planet. It includes many different geological structures, typically encompassing continents and ocean floors. Its formation is the result of complex geological processes that have taken billions of years since the planet's formation. The accretion process is one of the fundamental steps related to Earth's formation. This process is an evolution in which small particles within a dust and gas cloud in a protoplanetary disk orbiting the Sun came together to form the early shape of the planet. During the Sun's formation, a dense disk of gas and dust formed around it. This disk contained traces of hydrogen, helium, and other light elements, as well as heavier elements and minerals. Over time, material in this disk began to coalesce due to gravitational and electrostatic interactions. Small dust and gas particles merged to form larger aggregates. These aggregates grew larger as they attracted each other with their own gravity. This process, known as accretion, formed the early shape of the planet. With significant collisions in core formation, the planet's internal layers began to take shape. Core formation allowed denser and heavier elements to accumulate in the planet's center. This process led to the sinking of metals like iron and nickel, which formed the planet's core. Significant collisions also contributed to shaping the planet. During Earth's early history, collisions with celestial bodies of various sizes resulted in significant impacts. These collisions affected the planet's shape and composition, influencing the development of subsequent geological processes. As a result of all these processes, the early form of Earth took shape, and the planet's more complex geological evolution began. The accretion process is a fundamental part of Earth's evolution, playing a critical role in determining the planet's current shape and characteristics. The differentiation process is another significant evolution in Earth's early history. During this process, the planet's internal layers differentiated. Heavier elements sank towards the planet's center, forming the core, while lighter elements remained in the outer layers, forming the mantle and crust. This differentiation contributed to the complex formation of Earth's internal structure and the distinction of the crust from other layers. This process explains the differences in the chemical composition and physical properties of Earth's internal regions and has a significant impact on the planet's geological evolution. Magmatism and volcanism are considered expressions of Earth's internal energy sources. These processes result from the heat and pressure accumulated in the planet's interior. Magmatism is the process by which magma, a molten rock, forms in the Earth's interior and rises towards the crust. The composition of magma varies depending on factors such as depth and pressure, leading to the formation of different types of volcanic rocks. Volcanism, on the other hand, occurs when magma ascends to the surface and erupts, resulting in the formation of volcanoes, lava flows, lava bombs, and other volcanic features. These volcanic activities play a significant role in shaping the Earth's crust and influence the formation of continents and ocean floors. Magmatism and volcanism also contribute to the formation of new crustal material. Volcanoes help create new landmasses on the surface and reshape existing ones. Additionally, lava flows and volcanic ash contribute to soil formation and increase soil nutrient content. However, volcanic eruptions can also cause natural disasters, posing serious harm to surrounding ecosystems and human communities. Plate tectonics is an essential process demonstrating that Earth has a dynamic structure and that the crust is constantly changing. This process involves the brittle outer layer of the Earth, known as the lithosphere, being divided into large pieces that float on the mantle below. Movements at plate boundaries characterize different types of plate movements. For example, boundaries where two plates move apart are called divergent boundaries, while boundaries where two plates move towards each other are called convergent boundaries. These plate movements can trigger various geological events. For instance, collisions or separations of plates can cause earthquakes.
Mountain formation on the Earth's surface is also a result of plate tectonics, especially in regions where plates collide, creating folds and uplifts.
Additionally, magmatic activity and the formation of new crustal material occur at divergent boundaries.
This process is a fundamental factor influencing Earth's geological structure and surface shaping.
Plate tectonics is crucial for understanding the dynamic nature of our planet and forms the basis of the geological evolution of the Earth's crust from its formation to the present day.
Mountain formation is a result of the complex and varied geological processes shaping Earth's surface.
This process is often associated with natural events such as plate tectonics and volcanism. Mountains typically form at plate boundaries, particularly when plates collide or when one plate subducts beneath another.
Plate tectonics is one of the primary causes of mountain formation. But collision or subduction of plates results in strong geological folds and uplifts.
Such strong collisions can cause the layers of the Earth's crust to fold and uplift, leading to the formation of mountains.
Volcanism is another significant process that affects mountain formation.
During volcanic activities, magma rises towards the surface and accumulates volcanic materials.
Over time, these accumulations can transform into tall structures known as volcanic mountains.
Volcanic mountains typically form where magma reaches the surface and are associated with volcanic eruptions. Another layer of the Earth is the mantle. The mantle lies between the core and the crust and is approximately 2,900 kilometers thick, making up a large portion of Earth's total volume. Although the mantle is predominantly solid, its upper part, known as the asthenosphere, has a softer and more plastic consistency. The main components of the mantle are silicate minerals, with olivine and pyroxene, which contain magnesium and iron, being the most common. These minerals determine the mantle's density and physical properties. Additionally, peridotite, a rock rich in magnesium and iron, is also present in the mantle.
Under heat and pressure, the mantle can exhibit fluid-like behavior.
This leads to the formation of convection cells that move slowly beneath the mantle. These convection cells distribute Earth's heat and transport energy upwards, influencing many geological processes observed at the surface, such as plate tectonics and volcanic activity. The temperature of the mantle increases towards the center of the Earth. Near the surface, the mantle's temperature typically ranges from 500 to 900 degrees Celsius, while in the lower parts of the mantle, temperatures can reach thousands of degrees. Despite these high temperatures, the mantle generally remains solid because the minerals do not reach their melting points.
However, magma can form in some regions under specific temperature and pressure conditions, triggering volcanic activity. Pressure within the mantle also increases with depth.
While pressure is lower near the surface, it becomes significantly higher in the deeper layers of the mantle. This high pressure can alter the physical properties of minerals and affect the plastic behavior of the lower mantle. The asthenosphere, located in the upper mantle, has a more plastic and fluid nature due to the heat energy and stress coming from the lower mantle.
The asthenosphere plays a crucial role in the process of plate tectonics. Tectonic plates move on top of the asthenosphere, utilizing its fluid-like properties.
Different types of movements at plate boundaries can cause earthquakes, volcanism, and mountain formation. Since the asthenosphere lies beneath the tectonic plates, the high pressure on the plates can cause them to drift within the plastic region of the asthenosphere.
This drifting allows for the renewal of plates and contributes to the formation of new oceanic crust. The plasticity of the asthenosphere can influence changes in the Earth's surface.
Plate movements, including continental collisions, slips, and rifts, shape the topographic features of the Earth. These processes result in the formation of mountains, ocean trenches, mid-ocean ridges, and other geological structures.
The Earth's outer core is a significant component of the planet's inner structure, forming the outer layer of the core.
Composed of heavy metals like iron and nickel, it is approximately 2,270 kilometers thick.
The outer core lies just beneath the mantle and encases the inner core.
Its most distinctive feature is its liquid state, a result of iron melting under high temperature and pressure. The liquid nature of the outer core plays a crucial role in generating the planet's magnetic field. This magnetic field is associated with the rotation of the outer core and the movement of liquid metal currents.
The outer core also supports limited movement between the inner core and the mantle. Heat from the mantle causes the liquid part of the outer core to move and rotate.
This rotation contributes to the generation of Earth's magnetic field. The liquid nature and rotational motion of the outer core influence geological processes on Earth, such as triggering plate tectonics and volcanic activity. The temperature of the Earth's outer core is very high due to the planet's internal heat and pressure. Estimated temperatures range from approximately 4,000 to 6,000 degrees Celsius, keeping the outer core largely in a liquid state. This high temperature is attributed to the internal heat generated during the planet's formation from collisions and intense energy release. Natural processes like radioactive decay also contribute to the heating of the outer core. The Earth's inner core, located at the planet's center, is a solid layer composed predominantly of heavy metals like iron and nickel. The inner core is surrounded by the outer core and separated from the inner mantle. It is about 1,220 kilometers thick and accounts for about 1% of Earth's total volume. The solid structure of the inner core is formed by iron crystals solidifying under high pressure and relatively lower temperatures. The temperature of the inner core is higher than that of the outer core, estimated to be between 5,000 and 6,000 degrees Celsius. The relationship between Earth's core and its magnetic field explains the planet's internal dynamics and magnetic field formation. Earth's magnetic field is linked to the rotation of the inner core and the liquid metal currents in the outer core. The rotation of the inner core triggers the generation of the magnetic field. This rotation is essential for generating a strong magnetic field. The primary mechanism behind the formation of the magnetic field is the dynamo effect, which involves the movement of liquid metal currents in the outer core. Temperature differences within the Earth's inner core cause it to rotate and create liquid metal currents around the outer core. These currents contribute to the generation of the magnetic field. The magnetic field forms a magnetic shield around the Earth, deflecting most of the charged particles from the Sun and protecting the planet's surface. The magnetic field has magnetic poles, which align parallel to the rotation axis of the inner core. Seismic research is a crucial tool for understanding the Earth's internal structure. By using seismic waves generated by earthquakes and artificial sources, scientists can gather information about the structures deep within the Earth's layers. These studies provide detailed insights into the thickness, composition, and structural characteristics of the Earth's core, mantle, and crust. Seismic research also makes significant contributions to understanding plate tectonic processes, predicting volcanic activity, and identifying underground resources. Don't forget to subscribe for brand new scientific content.